What has happened, everybody? James Hancock here. I'm back to do a reaction video to the trailer for The Devil All the Time coming to Netflix on September 16th. Ordinarily, the premise might not necessarily make this movie jump to the front of the line for me, but the premise is in the 1960s, after World War II in southern Ohio, bizarre, compelling, and mentally disturbed people suffer from the war's psychological damages. You're like, all right, well, maybe it'll be good, maybe it won't. But it stars a who's who of superheroes that we all know and love from other movies. We've got Robert Pattinson, Batman himself. We've got Tom Holland, Spidey. We've got Bill Skarsgård. He's not really a superhero, but he's at least Pennywise. And we got the Winter Soldier himself, Sebastian Stan. And, I mean, the fact that they were able to, like, attract that much, like, big-name talent, there's got to be something to the screenplay. And outside of the superhero genre or horror genre, we got a bunch of other great actors as well. We got Elvis's granddaughter, Riley Keogh. We've got Jason Clarke, who I always really like. We got Mia Wasikowska, whose name I'm always a little bit wary on how to pronounce correctly. In any event, stunning cast. And I like the fact that it's a drama, it's a thriller. It's kind of the kind of movie that Hollywood used to make a lot more of, where you have these big, great big ensemble casts. It's not necessarily based on any sort of well-known IP. The director is one of those directors that I've been meaning to get around to for a very long time, Antonio Campos. He has movies like Simon Killer and After School, which I've always heard really good things about, but for whatever reason, I've never seen his movies. The closest I've come is, well, I saw The Punisher, the TV show on Netflix, and he directed one of the episodes. But apart from that, I am totally unfamiliar with his work. So, oh, you know what? I'm totally wrong. He directed a movie called Christine back in 2016, starring Rebecca Hall, and I did see that one. So I'm not completely unfamiliar with his movies. He's a talented director. There's absolutely no denying that. And if he's got this cast for The Devil All the Time, I'm very curious to see what this movie's all about. So let's just go ahead and let this trailer rip in 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday, Arvin.
We'll see who does the best American accent of all these European actors.
Well, this was your daddy's.
Brits tend to be experts at doing American accents. Anyone else?
Figure it's time to pass it on.
It's the best present I ever got. Thank you.
He's no longer a little boy from Queens.
How and why people from two points on a map without even a straight line between them can be connected is at the heart of our story in Knock'em Stiff.
You ever think about how we ended up orphans living in the same house?
I know what my daddy did.
Some people would say it's just dumb luck.
You take pictures?
I do. I see a smile pretty enough to photograph, that is.
Others would tell you it was God's plan.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness.
That ain't no preacher. He's as bad as they got on the damn radio.
When people look back on it, they ain't had no
other choice. Mood, like in the tension.
There's a lot of no good sons of bitches out there.
Excuse me, preacher. You got time for a sinner?
You know, I studied.
This looks really cool.
It's called the delusion.
I'm in.
A belief that is untrue. It is our delusion that lead us to sin.
What's up, puppy dog?
Delusions!
Some people were born just so they could be buried.
What I'm about to do, I do because I have to.
Is anybody in this cast actually
not because I want to
from America? Like, I know Sebastian Stan grew up here, but I think he was born in Romania. Mia Wasikowska, she's obviously Australian. Jason Clarke, I guess he's American, but it's funny. It seems like one of those vintage Americana kind of movies, but it's a largely European cast, so we shall see how it goes. But there's no denying the star power of that ensemble cast. And Netflix, at this point, I'm a broken record, but they continue for me to be the most exciting platform out there in terms of the wide range of types of content they're willing to tackle. It's like whether you're talking about sports documentaries or horror or superhero content or whatever the case might be, but it's like they'll try anything under the sun. They've got nearly 200 million monthly subscribers. They've got the built-in audience. And it just blows my mind that at a time where the entire industry is struggling to reinvent itself every single weekend, Netflix has a ton of new stuff coming out. And more often than not, at least one or two of them immediately jump to the front of the list. But if you look at HBO Max struggling to get out of the gate, they've only got a couple million. See something like CBS All Access, which is basically drowning in its own mediocrity. And then you got things like Peacock, like who cares? Amazon Studios is doing some good stuff, but Disney Plus, they're really the only like legit competition. I think they've got 60 million subscribers, which is obviously enormous. And if Disney Plus were to create a brand within the brand where you could actually have adult content, you know, R-rated, PG-13, etc. Right now, Disney Plus is very family-friendly, but if they have the ability to show something that's a little bit more edgy, then I think Disney Plus is going to be the only real rival for Netflix moving forward. But at this point, Netflix just has such a massive advantage. At any rate, Devil All the Time, September 16th, I'm marking my calendar. That'll be at the top of my to-do list. I think that looks incredible, but let me know what you think down in the comments below. If you want to talk more, give me a shout on Twitter at Colbrax. But remember to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, hit that notification bell. But more importantly, as always, onwards and upwards.